क्लास 11 नीट जेई सेक्शन कवरिंग टॉपिक वन डायमेंशनल मोशन कवरिंग टॉपिक वन डायमेंशनल मोशन और मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन दिस इज टोटली क्वेश्चन आंसर सेक्शन एमसीक्यू टाइप only for NEET and JEE aspirants. Question number one. A car covers the first half of the distance between two places at 40 km per hour and another half at 60 km per hour. The average speed of the car is this two points, let the distance between two points is 2x. It covers first half, that is x, with a speed according to question 40 km/h. 40 km per hour, that is I take the distance in kilometer, 2x kilometer, and next half, that is another x kilometer, with a speed 60 km/h. You have to find the average velocity or average speed, average speed of the car. Time t1 to cover from A to B equal to x by 40, distance by velocity, this is time. And time t2 for B to C, time t2 equal to x by 60, V average equal to total distance by total time, that is 2x by x by 40 plus x by 60, 2x, x, 1 by 40 plus 1 by 60, 2 by 120, 2 into 120 by 5, that is cancelled, 24, 48. The average speed of the car is 48 km per hour. Question number 2. A car moves a distance of 200 meter. It covers the first half of the distance at a speed of 40 km per hour and the second half of the distance at a speed of V. The average speed of the speed is 48 km per hour. Find the value of V. I repeat. A car moves a distance 200 meter. It covers the first half of the distance at speed of 40 km per hour and the second half of the distance at a speed of V. The average speed is 48 km per hour, the value of V. The one is second half of the distance to cover for the V calculate kut to have it. Total distance 200 meter, I convert it into total distance 200 meter, I convert it into kilometer, 200 meter, that is equal to 0.2 kilometer. First half means 0.1 kilometer and second half is 0.1 kilometer. First half, it covers first half with 40 kilometer per hour. And second half with speed of V, the average velocity is V average equal to 48 किलोमीटर पर आवर नाउ एवरेज स्पीड होच्छे टोटल डिस्टेंस बाय टोटल टाइम दैट इज 0.2 बाय टोटल टाइम टेकिंग फर्स्ट हाफ 0.1 बाय 40 प्लस 0.1 बाय वी इक्वल टू 48 यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट इट रिमूविंग दिस पार्ट जीरो पॉइंट टू मल्टीप्लाइंग बोथ बाय डिनोमिनेटर एंड न्यूमरेटर बाय 10 देन इट इज टू इट इज 1/40 इट विल 1/V इट विल नॉट हैम्पर द रिजल्ट 48 नाउ क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन 48 बाय 40 प्लस 48 बाय वी इक्वल टू 2 दैट इज 48 बाय वी इक्वल टू 2 माइनस 48 बाय 40 48 by V equal to 40, 80 minus 48. By V equal to 32 by 40. 16 to 16 3. 2V equal to 120, V equal to 60. The average, the speed of the second half is 60 km per hour. You can use a short form to calculate the average speed for the math. The short form is V average equal to 2V1 V2 by V1 plus V2. This is the average short form for average speed. When the two speed is given for two equal halves, it is 48 average 2 into V1 first speed of the first part equal to 40 into V by 40 plus V. Cancel karo 2 24 2 20 12 2 be a 10, 2 be a 6, 2 be a 5, 2 be a 3, and that is 3 equal to all cancel 5V by 40 plus V. Cross multiplication 120 plus 3V equal to 5V, that is V equal to 60 km per hour. This is the short form. You can apply it to for time management. Question number three. A bus traveling the first one-third distance at a speed of 10 km per hour, the next one-third 20 km per hour, and the last one-third is 60 km per hour. The average speed of the bus is easy math, very easy to solve it. let the total distance be 3x, 3x, x, it covers first half with speed of 10 km per hour, second part with 20 km per hour, and third part is 60 km per hour. Average speed, total distance by total time, that is 3x by x by 10 plus x by 20 plus x by 60, that is x cancel 3 by 1 by 10 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 60. That is 3 by LCM 60, 6 plus 3 plus 1, that is 3 by 10 into 60, that is 18 kilometer per hour. This is the average speed of the bus in the total journey. Question number 4. A car moves from x to y with a uniform speed of vu and returns to y with a uniform speed of vd. The average speed of this round trip is question number 4. A car moves from x to y with a uniform speed of vu and return to return to x with a speed of vd. The car is moving from x to y with a speed of vu, return to x from y with a speed of vd. Average speed, let the distance be s. So the v average, that is average speed equal to total distance 2s by s by vu plus s by vd. We have to cancel s to vu vd by vu plus vd. This is the average speed. This formula I used in the earlier math to calculate the average speed in the question number 2 in shorter form. Be careful. This is the average speed. If it is average velocity, this is speed. If it is average velocity, then the answer will be 0, no calculation needed, because from x to y and y to x, the total displacement becomes 0. In case of average speed, total distance s plus s, that is 2s. In case of average velocity, the total displacement is 0, because it starts from x end at x, the displacement is 0, that is average velocity, total displacement by total time, total displacement is 0, so the answer will be 0. Be careful. Next, question number 5. A car moves along a straight line whose equation of motion is s equal to, equation of motion is s equal to 12t plus 3t square minus 2t cube. A car is moves along a straight line whose equation of motion is s equal to 12t plus 3t square minus 2t cube, where s is in meters and t in seconds. The velocity of the car at the start will be, that is the velocity of the car, that is the instantaneous velocity of the car at t equal to 0 time. V instantaneous velocity equal to ds by dt. You have to differentiate s with respect to time, that is, dt of 12t plus 3t square minus 2t cube, that is v instantaneous equal to ddt of 12t plus ddt of 3t square minus ddt of 2t cube. This is 12 plus say 3 into 2t plus minus 2 into 3t square. 2 into 3t square, 3 into 2t, 12t. That is V instantaneous, the equation of instantaneous velocity, 12 plus 60 minus 60 square. V instantaneous at t equal to 0 time, because the initial velocity is needed to calculate at t equal to 0 time. T equal to 0 will be, put t equal to 0 here, that is 12 meter per second, that is the instantaneous velocity at start, 12 meter per second. Next question, just wait. The position x of a particle, varies with time t as x equal to a t square minus b t cube. The acceleration will be 0 at time t equal to, that is, you have to calculate the time t when the acceleration is 0. The position time of equation is given, x equal to, position time equation is given x equal to, just wait, x equal to a t square minus b t cube. You have to find the time when the acceleration, that is instantaneous acceleration, is 0. First you have to calculate instantaneous velocity, v instantaneous, that is ddt of x, that is ddt of a t square minus b t cube, that is v instantaneous equal to a into 2t minus b into 3t square. That is V instantaneous equal to 280 minus 3B square. Now we have to find the instantaneous acceleration. Now we have to find the instantaneous acceleration, that is dv by dt, that is acceleration equal to ddt of instantaneous velocity, v instantaneous, that is acceleration equal to ddt of 280 minus 3b t square. We have to differentiate with respect to t, that is acceleration instantaneous, acceleration instantaneous, acceleration instantaneous, equal to 2a minus 3b into 2t, t square is 2t. Now, in the question given acceleration is 0, you have to find the time when acceleration, instantaneous acceleration is 0. So put instantaneous acceleration a equal to 0, that is 0 equal to 2a minus 6 bt, that is t equal to 2a by 6b, that is a by 3b. This is the required time when the acceleration is 0, a by 3b. The question, next question, question of most probably question number 6, just wait, I have to check the time limit of the video, I have to check the time limit of the video, 8 or 9 minutes more. Next question, similar question. Differentiation is very important to solve the problem. You have to learn the differentiation. Just watch my previous video. The name of my channel is Physics for All by Jayanta Sir. Like and subscribe it to get the notification for the future video. Question number 9, motion of a particle is given by the equation displacement s. Motion of a particle is given by the equation displacement s equal to 3t cube plus 7t square plus 7t square plus 14t plus 8. This is the displacement equation of a particle. The value of the acceleration of the particle at t equal to 1 second. You have to calculate the acceleration at t equal to 1 second. That is the instantaneous acceleration of the particle at t equal to 1 second. First calculate v instantaneous, that is the ddt of s. That is ddt of 3t cube plus 7t square plus 14t plus 8. Just write the result, that is v instantaneous equal to, just write the result of the differentiation, 3t cube, it will be 9t square after differentiation, 9t square plus 7t square, it will be 14t, it will be 14 and 8 will be 0. Next calculate instantaneous acceleration, that is ddt of v instantaneous, that is ddt of, this is for class for NEET and JEE, the question will be not so easy. A instantaneous equal to ddt of 9t square, that is 18t plus 14t, it will be 14 plus 14 will become 0. Now you have to calculate the acceleration, instantaneous acceleration at t equal to 1 second. Put t equal to 1 at the equation. Instantaneous acceleration at t equal to 1 second will be instant put t equal to 1, 80 plus 40, that is 32 with proper unit meter per second square or centimeter per second square and so on. Just wait, I have to check the time limit. One more question. Next question, maybe it will be question number 10 or 9. Just hold it. Question number 10. A particle moves along a straight line such that the displacement at any time t is given by the displacement at any time, that is instantaneous displacement at any time t is given by equation s equal to t cube minus 60 square plus 3t plus 4. S equal to t cube minus 60 square plus 3t plus 4. This is the equation given relating the displacement and time. You have to find the velocity when the acceleration is zero. This is a very interesting question. You have to find the velocity when acceleration is zero. So instantaneous velocity ddt of displacement, that is ddt of t cube minus 60 square plus 3t plus 4, that is v instantaneous. Just calculate the differentiation, 3t square minus 12t plus 3. Next, find out the acceleration. This is the equation of velocity, instantaneous velocity. The acceleration, instantaneous acceleration, equal to ddt of v instantaneous, ddt of v instantaneous, that is, I have to replace the pen, ddt of 3t square minus 12t plus 3, that is, the result is instantaneous acceleration, result is 60 minus 12. You have to find the time when acceleration is 0 and then find the velocity at that time. You have to find the time when acceleration is 0. Put 0 here, 0 equal to 60 minus 12. That is t equal to 2 seconds. At 2 seconds, it was the acceleration is zero. The velocity, you have to find the instantaneous velocity at time when the acceleration is zero. That is at t equal to 2 seconds. Put the t equal to 2 here. 12 minus 12 into 2, 24 plus 3. That is minus 9 meter per second. This is the required answer. Minus 9 meter per second. Almost 30 minutes. So I have to end the video. This is only for NEET and JEE aspirants. So the question will be more tough, and you have to learn the basic of the physics. Just watch my previous video. My channel name is Physics for All by Joyanto Sir. Subscribe and like it to get the notification of the future video, which will be uploaded time to time. Thank you. Have a good day.